Spinola. I am an after-sales engineer from Felicity Solar. Very glad to be here to communicate with all of you through the way of live streaming. Today, we are going to talk about how to set parameter for solar system, because the wrong parameter setting will cause the battery or inverter more easily damaged. I hope that this live streaming can reduce this situation and make the system run more accurately and safely, and you could serve customers more better. Okay, let's go. At first, let's look at the content. The first is the communication between the inverter and the battery. Second, how to set the parameter for your system. This is important. When your system parameters are set incorrectly, which can lead to easy damage or reduced cycle life for your battery. Okay, let's talk about communication between the inverter and the battery. In the products of Felicity, only lithium batteries can communicate with the inverter. The communication function of the inverter can read the information of the BMS, sorry, of the BMS, the SOC of the battery, the charge and discharge current, and the battery voltage. How to communicate with the battery and the inverter? If you use IVEN inverter, just connect the communication cable. Connect one end of the communication cable to the COM port on the battery, and the other end to the RS485 port on the inverter. We can see this peak just like this, and set the leaf mode on the inverter screen. The battery type setting page is program 8. For the low frequency inverter, such as IVPS, IVPM, and IVQM, there are some different settings. The battery type setting page is program 5, and need to set program 16, which set to BMS information. However, for the low frequency inverter, due to hardware limitations, the SOC of the battery cannot be viewed. Okay, let's move on. The second part is to set the parameter, and the correct parameter setting can be safer, more efficient, and more economical. Let's talk about IVEN. The IVEN inverter is same as low frequency inverter, such as IVPS, IVPM, and IVQM. Today, we are mainly talking about charging priority and output priority, charging current, battery type, charging voltage, cutoff voltage, and parallel mode. Okay, sorry. Wait a moment. Okay, let's move on. This is IVEN user menu and program one and program two do not need to be set. For program two, it's all 50 Hz in Africa. That is utility input range setting. Let's see program 3. The function of the UPS is that when the utility cut off, it can quickly switch to the battery to supply the power to the load. Both modes have requirements for the utility. We can see the requirement. And we can see in UPS mode, when the utility is lower than 170 volts, the inverter and the utility will be disconnected. And in APL mode, when the utility is lower than 790 volts, the inverter will be disconnected the utility. And that is, APL has lower requirements for the utility. So, if local utility is not well, I recommend to set APL. And let's move on, let's look at program 4. This is program 4. The program 4 is about output source priority. There are three sources totally: PV, utility, and battery. They all can supply power to the load. The USB and SUB are standby modes. They can work longer without utility. In both modes, the batteries supply power to the load only when PV and utility are insufficient. The SBU mode is an economic mode. It can set the voltage point for battery and utility switching. Let's look at program 12 and program 13. When the battery voltage is higher than 54 volts, it will switch to the battery to power the load. If set low voltage, turn back to the battery is 46 volts. When the battery voltage is lower than 46 volts, it will switch to the utility to power the load. In the setting, I recommend setting to 51 volts. In this way, when the battery voltage drops below 51 volts and there is no utility, it cannot be switched to utility to supply the power to the load, and the battery can also supply power to the load for a long time. Okay, let's see program 5. Program 5 is about charger priority. In CSO mode, PV will charge the battery first, and the utility will charge the battery when PV is unavailable, such as at night and in rainy days. The SNU mode can charge battery quickly because PV and utility will charge battery together. And only PV can charge the battery in OSO mode. And program 6, program 7 is for charging current. Before setting this program, you need to consider the charge and discharge ratio of the battery. The charge and discharge ratio of the lithium battery is 0.4 to 0.5C. And for lead acid battery is 0.2C. If the settings are incorrect, the cycle life of the battery may be affected. When you have 4 PCS, 12 volt, 200 amps hour lead acid battery, the max charging current should be set to 40 amps. Why should be setting to 40 amps? Because according to the charge and discharge ratio of lead acid battery is 0.2C. So 200 amps hour times 0.2C is 40 amps. So I recommend set it to 40 amps. If you use 10 kilowatt hour lithium battery, according to the ratio, it should be set to 80 amps. Okay, let's move on. The program 7 is only to set the utility charging current. If your system has enough solar panels, you can set to 10 amps, the program 7. For example, if program 6 is set to 60 amps, and the PV charging current is 40 amps, then the utility can only charge the battery with 20 amps. Okay, let's see the battery type setting. The battery type is set according to the battery. For Felicity's lithium battery, it can communicate, so set to LEAP mode. For other brand batteries, you can set to user. If the battery is GEM battery, please set AGN. If the battery is OPZV, it can be set FLD. And program 9 is about buck charging voltage setting, which means constant voltage. At this stage, the battery will charge at a constant voltage. And program 10 is floating charging voltage. After the battery is full charged, use a small current to continue charging the battery, which is called floating charging, also as known as trickle charging. The purpose of floating charge is mainly to extend the service life of the battery and maintain sufficient power. If it is our Felicity lead acid battery, program 9 and program 10 can use the default value. If you want to set by yourself, need to pay attention to the floating charging voltage. It's best not higher than 57.6 volt. If it is another brand of battery, you can set to the corresponding battery type. and then use the default value. If you want to set charging voltage by yourself, you can set the battery type to user defined mode, and then set the charging voltage according to the battery menu. And the setting value of program 11 should be lower than 46 volt or 48 volt. Otherwise, it will cause excessive discharged battery and affect the cycle life of the battery. And let's look at program 14. Program 14 is overload bypass function. If you set enable in program 14, when overload occurs, the utility will directly supply power to the load. Okay, move on. Let's look at program 28. It's about AC output mode. Yeah. If you only have one inverter, please set it to SIG. When the inverters are used in parallel with single phase, please set PAL. If inverters are in parallel, and before starting up battery, please connect all N wires of AC power together. For example, we can see this picture. If you have five inverter in three phase parallel, like this picture, you need to set the first three inverter to 3P1 and the fourth to 3P2 and the last one to 3P3. And you can look at this pic. The green line is communication cable. Oh, sorry. The green line is sharing current cable, and the red line is communication cable. Alright, that's all for my presentation. Now, it's time for questions and answer. If you have any question, you can type them out. Please feel free to ask questions. Everyone, now it's time for questions and answer. If you have any question, you can type them out. Please feel free to ask question. Sorry, there is no French live streaming yet. But at the future, maybe. Hello everyone, we will be back in 5 minutes, so please ask your question. Okay. 嗯，about the 4G batteries setting is about that. The 4G batteries capital is about 9.6 kilowatt hour. And you should处理一次的那时候，about，对对对，2400 kilowatt。And 9.6 divided 4 is 2400 kilowatt. And 2 1400 kilowatt divide 450 is 5. So you need 5 PCS panels.
ABMs to train,
Hi, Jerry. Yes, according to the battery and inverter amps, to choose the breaker. Can you tell me the battery model? Hello, Taiwan. When the lithium battery is full charged, the voltage is about 54 or 55 volts.
This voltage is full.
Hello everyone, live streaming is finished, so see you next time. Bye.
Thank you.